Blade Assault is a roguelite action platformer in which you attempt to overthrow an evil cyberpunk government by hitting the attack button a lot. Blade Assault closely follows the roguelite formula. There are randomly generated rooms of enemies, randomly distributed power-ups, and upgrades you can carry over between runs. There are a few characters with different playstyles and weapons, and the power-ups allow you to customize them even further. It's not likely to change your opinion on roguelites, but it does a decent job of the broad strokes. However, the specifics of the game let it down. Most enemies are easy to beat, but require time-consuming or boring tactics. Early enemies can be stunlocked by spamming the attack button, and even late into the game, button mashing is often a safe strategy. Blade Assault likes to throw so many enemies at you at once that you can't see any of them individually. With most builds, there will also be one of three elemental effects from your abilities flying across the screen, obscuring projectiles and uninterruptible attacks alike. You can dodge a lot of it, but you will eventually get hit by attacks you couldn't have seen coming due to the sheer volume of enemy attacks on screen. Exacerbating things is that many enemies and bosses have enormous amounts of health, and you have comparatively little. Even if you take as many health power-ups in a run as possible, your health will be ground down by attrition as you wail on enemies that seem to never stop spawning. On top of this, each run of the game clocks in at around an hour and 50 minutes, which makes it more about maintaining patience than having skill. The power-up system also has some issues. Alternative elemental power-ups for the same slot, for example dash attack, will be offered over and over, even if they're weaker than the ones you already have. This limits your choices to the one or two options that aren't downgrades. This problem is smaller if you only use a single element, which isn't a big deal because all the three elements have similar power-ups anyway. The items provide most of the variety, though most of them are still unremarkable. There are also weapon ability upgrades, but you can't check them from the menu, so you just have to remember what you bought hours ago. Many of the item and power-up descriptions don't make sense or don't do what they appear to describe. Some are too vague or use obtuse language, and it's not a fun challenge to guess what a power-up does because the description is wrong. Once you have a few of the better power-ups, the game starts feeling less placid and instead becomes chaotic and at least a little enjoyable. The controls themselves are responsive. It's just everything else that makes it feel terrible. The game's character art is charming, the environmental art is nice, and the enemy art is mostly boring, which averages out to good enough. However, when it's often impossible to see through the chaos, it's tough to appreciate the art as a cohesive whole. At least the music does a good job of setting the mood. The story is told through occasional, poorly translated text boxes. It's basic cyberpunk stuff about a resistance group trying to destroy their oppressors, but consistent grammatical errors undercut any dramatic tension. But this is a roguelite, and the story is a tiny portion of your time with the game. There is some classic roguelite fun to be found in the game, with some of the more powerful builds being button-mashing fun. But ultimately, I think this game isn't worth playing unless you're desperate for this exact flavor of roguelite jank. Blade Assault is available now on Steam for $17.99, but is currently 20% off, and it will come later to Nintendo Switch and PlayStation 4.